This is Susan Wheelbanks with BlendedInsight.com. I am a holistic and integrative healing arts practitioner, an intuitive, and an energy healer. In this podcast, I share tips, tools, and suggestions that have helped me along my path in hopes of inspiring and helping you along yours. Let's get started with today's podcast topic. Hello, bright souls. Thank you so much for joining me on another podcast. I hope this finds you well. We're going into July, so that's exciting. And we have a full moon coming up in July, so we've got a lot of big things still continuing to occur. And so I just wanted to dive into today's podcast topic. And this is really more of a recentering and a pep talk because it's been so crazy. It doesn't matter if you believe in astrology or you follow astrology. I'm not an astrologist, but I am very in tune to Earth's cycles. And so I do try to stay up on what's going on because I find it affects me and it affects my client base. I can always tell when there's a lot going on in the sky because I get a lot of private sessions booked and people start to feel it, whether they realize it or not. And honestly, most of the time when we get on private session calls, and the person starts describing when their emotions or physical things or whatever happened, the days that they occur are usually on big planetary days without them even knowing it. And so here lately, the cycles have been changing every 2 days, the planetary alignments and things like that. And so it's just been a really big emotional week. So a lot of relationship stuff going on, heightened emotions, and exhaustion. And if you're energetically sensitive, like most of us are, you may have been feeling more tired lately and more out of balance. I know for myself, I felt very out of character. I was getting sucked into things that I wouldn't normally get sucked into. And I have the knowledge of what's going on, but it doesn't stop me from still getting sucked into it. Even with all the work I'm doing. So it doesn't matter. This is a practice. It is a spiritual practice. It is a daily practice. We are still flawed. We are still human. I mean, I'm speaking for myself. So it's easy to get on a spiritual ego trip where you feel like you should be holier than thou because you have the knowledge, you're on the path, you're conscious, you're trying to evolve. But the thing is, we're still human and we're still learning, growing, evolving, which requires time and mistakes. And so I am extending to you what I've been extending to myself. And that is, I am human. I am not going to beat myself up for the way that I feel, for the things that I've been getting sucked into, even for behaviors that I've had, you know, like getting very petty about stuff. I mean, last week, I was like, oh my gosh, I feel so petty. And I know that it's not helpful. I know it isn't the high road, but I'm also not denying that I feel very petty right now. And I feel like holding people accountable for their actions, even though it likely will not make a difference. This is what I want to do. And I was laughing at myself because I'm like, what is going on with me? And this is after meditating and cutting cords and cleaning myself and shielding myself and doing all the things that I share with you that I do. And so the way that I looked at it is, this is just part of my evolution. There's something here for me to learn. There's something here for me to grow past. And so chances are you've had a little bit of that too. And if it hasn't been you personally, maybe it's people around you, because that is the other thing I've noticed. People close to me, they've been having a lot of really big emotional situations. And so we're all in it together. And so some of my closest friends, you know, having lots of conversations throughout the day. I think I've been on the phone a lot this week with my friends going, what is wrong with us? What is going on? Is it the planets? Is it the pandemic? And so I think it's a little bit of all of that. The energy of the masks and the opinions and the angst around it is exhausting. I can barely stand to even open my Facebook because you've got people, you know, friends of mine. I wear a mask because I care about people. And then you have people on the other side that are like, wearing a mask doesn't do anything. And you know what? There's different levels of truth, and both sides they irritate me, just like political stuff irritates me, because you have people posting for the president that they want and the one that they don't. We all have our opinions, and publicly blasting it just irritates the people that don't agree with you. And at the end of the day, it doesn't change anyone's opinion one way or the other. So is there a point? Not really. So I thought, okay, well, if I didn't have a business Facebook page, I would just inactivate my account and move on. But because I do have a business Facebook page and I do need to log in to connect with people who are like-minded and who I want to serve and uplift, I stay connected on Facebook and just unfollow people. But my gosh, at the end of it, I think I'll only follow two pages, Pranic Healing and probably my own, and that'll be it. Dr. Northrup, I'll follow her. I love her. So there's like a couple of pages that I like to follow, but right now the energy is just so heavy that it's tough. And I've had this conversation with so many people over the last week. And, you know, for me, humor is a go-to. I do energy healing. I do readings. I do my spiritual practice. But at the end of the day, the people that love and relate to me the most are the people that appreciate my authenticity. I don't sit here and try to act like a holier-than-thou spiritual teacher or spiritual practitioner or any of that. I understand the human emotions because I'm authentic about it. I'm not trying to be inauthentic in any way. I am so flawed. So I was really feeling it midweek. And so I took an Epsom salt bath, which felt really great. And my sleep was also disturbed this past week. I've been going to Orange Theory, so I've been sore. And I was like, oh my gosh, my sleep is disturbed. So I was like, okay, let's reel this in. There's a lot going on for everyone, but I have to take good care of myself in order to take good care of other people. So I just said, all right, enough is enough. I've been doing my meditation practice, but I'm still getting sucked in. So what can I do? I got off Facebook. I'm like, I can't do it. I can't be on social media right now because I respect everyone's position of what they want to do. At the end of the day, I want to send everyone love for doing what they feel is right. We all have the choice to do that. And I believe that we all make decisions because we believe that is the best decision at the time. When you learn something new or you get new information or you change your mind, oftentimes we'll look back and say, oops, I thought that was the best decision, but maybe it wasn't. In the moment, we can't see it because when you're deceived, you don't know you're deceived. That's why you're deceived. So we have to give ourselves credit for showing up, give ourselves a break for being human, even on the spiritual path, even when we behave petty, because I can get super petty. I really can. And I can also, after I realize that I'm being really petty, I do make amends. I apologize. I try to make the best of, you know, best of the situation, clean it up. I mean, I really own my stuff. And I actually have remorse about it. And I try not to do it. And I don't do it very often, but I've been known I can do it. I am a human. And so last night, I went to bed early. I got plenty of sleep. I took the Epsom salt bath. I'm still exercising, doing all the things to take care of my physical body and my spiritual health, doing breath work. Breath work helps you release a lot. And then just honoring my emotions instead of trying to figure it out, because I'm very analytical. It's easy for me to go down the rabbit hole of like, what is going on? Why am I feeling this way? Am I corded? Well, I could be, but I cut cords and really trying to troubleshoot, which is actually distracting me from just accepting that, hey, I'm feeling like this. And if I have a mindful approach to it and say, okay, I'm feeling like this. All feelings are valid. Let me just let this feeling be for a little bit and see if it passes. And once I got into a position of surrender, I felt so much better. And so I just wanted to extend that to you to say, it's a really difficult time right now. Even though the world is opening up, people that are in the workforce that have to wear masks, which restrict your breathing, they're hot. You know, a lot of us believe that they're the opposite of helpful for many ways, for many reasons. And it doesn't really matter which side that you fall on. It doesn't matter. The end of the day is that it's something very new after people have been cooped up for 3 months. And so the world isn't completely back to normal. For me, I'm still not allowed to travel, so I can't leave the state like I normally would. And so there's that buildup of energy where the world as we've known it has changed. And so everyone's trying to adjust. And because people are in fear about this virus, some people, chances are you're not if you're drawn to my work. I'm not afraid of it. But there are so many people that are just kind of blindly following the masses or what they believe to be the authority. And they're doing it because they believe that that's the right thing. So, you know, their heart is in the right place. But because they're blindly following, they're fearful. And so they're walking around in fear. And that energy is circulating so heavy right now. And those of us that are sensitive, we feel it. And whether or not we think that we're going to be affected, we are. And so I have just really been backing down a little bit and giving myself more time to just be, more time to get outside, walk the trails. Here in Colorado, it's beautiful, so I can walk the trails, get outside. But even then, when I'm on the trails and other people are out on the trails with their masks and their fear, I can feel it. And so I start to feel as though I'm not able to get a release or a break, like energetically. That's where breath work has really been beneficial for me. Epsom salt baths, my sauna, Orange Theory, that's been great. Because most of us that are going back to Orange Theory are not afraid of the virus and we're basically over it. and so that's been really great. And so it's kind of just finding those little ways that really help you to feel a little bit more grounded and a little bit more like yourself. Because that's the other thing. Lots of people just don't feel like themselves. And that's because the way the world is behaving is not like ourselves. We're evolving into a new place. We're on the train whether we want to be or not. And so it's really just how are we going to adjust and go with the flow and make it as easy as possible. And that's where trying to release the resistance comes from. Because, you know, the whole mask thing, I don't wear a mask. I choose not to wear a mask. And I wear a mask in places where I have to in order to get the service or in order to do whatever I have to do. But if it's an option to wear the mask, I'm not wearing a mask. And so I deal with people who get very angry, try to give me dirty looks. And I can feel all of their rage and anger, which really for me doesn't make sense because if the mask protects you, then you're protected. So why are you worried about me? And then the other opposite side of that is, well, you could be asymptomatic and shedding it. Okay, but if you're wearing a mask, you're protected. So that already shows you that you don't believe in what you're doing, but you're doing it because you feel like you have to do it. And my stance is because I do work in the medical environment. And so there's just been too many decades of research on when and where to wear a mask. And so that's what I'm personally choosing to do. And also, I'm an energy healing for crying. I'm an energy healer for crying out loud. My energy is really clean. And so when I'm walking around, actually, my aura is nice and clean and I'm sending out a healing presence. And so I just refuse to be brought down by what other people think and feel and do. At the end of the day, we have free will choice until we don't. And like I said, like when I go get my nails done, if I choose to splurge, it's required to wear a mask. So I will. When I went to get my hair done, I went and wore a mask. In Orange Theory, when we go, we have to wear a mask in the lobby. Okay, fine, I'll wear it. But in places where I don't have to, I'm not going to. And that establishment or the city has given us the option to not wear it if we don't want to. And so it's a choice and I'm able to take it and I'm doing it, even though people seem to get really angry about it. And I know a lot of you have had those same experiences because we've talked about it personally. And so again, just shielding yourself, forgive yourself for what you think you have or have not done. Forgive yourself for the way you may or may not have been activated, the way you may or may not have acted out against someone or been petty, doing the forgiveness work for others and for yourself, and just picking yourself up and trying to do better the next day. That's really all we can do. Really trying to do better the next moment. Because when things are really chaotic, sometimes we slip. I mean, we're human. That's what happens. The difference is that we pick ourselves back up and we do have a higher goal. We want to walk the higher path and we are walking it. We may fall down, but we get up and we keep going and we own our mistakes and we make amends where we can and continue to do more good than harm. Hopefully we're not harming at all. And maybe it's intentionally, unintentionally. You know, because when you do energy healing and your aura is really clean, your words and your actions come across much more strongly than someone who is just numb and unconscious. And you're held accountable to a higher level because the spiritual beings know you know better. And so when I act petty, I am like, oh no, let me make this right immediately and get back on the path because I already know that I'm held to such a high standard. And so, and that's all of us if you're drawn to my work. So really that's all I have for this healing today. I just really want to work on cleaning out your channels so that you feel an emotional release and shielding you because the emotions have been insane for me and for most people. And just know you are loved and it's okay. You're allowed to make mistakes. And guess what? You're also allowed to change your mind. Maybe you feel like wearing a mask is stupid today and tomorrow you feel like it's the best thing ever. And guess what? If that happens for me, I'm embracing it because I'm allowed to change and grow. I'm allowed to learn new information and then change my stance. But it's a process and we all have our own time, space that we make changes or learn things or that we evolve. And at the end of the day, I just try to stay neutral. Judgments are part of being human. When I notice myself being judgmental inside my mind or out loud, I really just try to reel it in and come back to center and be neutral and get back into a spiritual state of mind. So, woo, let's do a healing. So if you can just uncross your arms and legs, start to focus on your breathing. I'm going to really clean your solar plexus for this because that's where we hold our emotions. And I know it's been tough. So sometimes when I'm cleaning the solar plexus, you might feel a little nauseous or a little emotional. So let's just relax and let it be. Just receive the healing and focus on your breathing. That really helps to release things. I'm doing some grounding work and then I will run some shields. Okay, and so it is. We can come back into our bodies. And for those of you who are on my YouTube channel, I want to start saying this at the beginning of my videos. I'm asked the same questions that are already answered so many times, and I honestly just don't have the time to get to them all. So if you read the description of all my videos, it can save you a lot of time and also me a lot of time to just repeat the same answer, because 90% of the questions, I'd actually say 98% of the questions are already answered in the description or in my video, Common Questions Answered. So I wanted to say that. And I wanted to thank everyone who has left me a review and a comment and connected with me and referred my work. I appreciate you so much. Let's just keep it moving. That's all we can do, is keep it moving. Give yourself a break. Do some self-care and know that you're doing the best you can. And you're seen, you're validated, you're loved, you're appreciated. And thank you for tuning in. I hope you have a great week. Take care. Bye-bye.